Pete Davidson is one of Saturday Night Live's standout stars. But has the show exploited his mental health issues for ratings, while other cast members secretly hate him? Keep watching to learn the shocking truth. At only 17, Pete Davidson was discovered by Nick Cannon, who took the younger comedian under his wing. Cannon gave him a spot co-hosting his morning radio show, Rollin' with Nick Cannon, took him on the road, and helped Davidson book frequent appearances on MTV shows, including Nick Cannon Presents Wild and Out, Philosophy, and Guy Code. Like many comedians, Davidson parlayed his comedy into acting, landing a guest role in a 2013 episode of Brooklyn Nine-Nine. He followed that with small acting gigs on TV and in shorts, before getting a call to be in a scene of the 2015 Amy Schumer film Trainwreck, the role which would change his life. In an interview on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon, Trainwreck director Judd Apatow said that Schumer responded to his request for new young talent by saying,
"The funniest person is this 20-year-old kid, Pete Davidson."
Soon, Davidson was on set in a scene with Schumer and Bill Hader. Davidson said that only a day after filming, he got a call from Bill Hader who told him, quote, "I recommended you to Lorne Michaels." Davidson joked,
"So I blame that and everything else that has happened to me since then on Bill Hader."
Though many comedians work and prepare for years to perfect their Saturday Night Live audition, Pete Davidson's surprise recommendation from Bill Hader meant he kind of had to wing it, especially since he wasn't a fan of the show. In 2020, he told CBS Sunday Morning,
"I didn't know it was still around."
Is that true? You know,
yeah, I mean, like, when you're 16, you're not watching, like, political midnight shows.
For his audition, he went with a simple stand-up routine rather than the usual impressions or sketch characters. It worked. Davidson told Seth Meyers that Lorne Michaels personally called and said, quote, "I don't know what to do with you, but you got the show." Davidson debuted on SNL on September 27, 2014, in the show's 40th season. He was just 20 years old and felt out of place from the very beginning, insecure about his age. He told CBS Sunday Morning, "I was like 10, 12 years younger than everybody else, so it felt like it was a joke." Though Pete Davidson sometimes found himself in silly, slapstick sketches, his niche quickly became his recurring appearances on the Weekend Update segment of SNL. Davidson was at his best, giving provocative takes from a refreshing, youthful perspective, and his role as resident young person was an instant hit. But he soon grew tired of having only one role. In a 2015 Weekend Update segment about turning 21, he joked that his resident young person bits were his only calling card.
"How did I get on this show?"
He told SF Gate in 2015 that his age was an issue. "It's a crutch. People could be like, he's really good, but he's young. Or they say, he's really bad because he's young. I don't think it has anything to do with my comedy. I just try to be as funny as possible." In 2020, he told Charlamagne Tha God that even as he's gotten older, he's still treated the same in the sketches.
"Like, I'm literally painted out to be like this big, dumb idiot. Like, even all my sketches are just me being like, okay, sure."
When asked if he felt he'd outgrown the show, Davidson admitted,
"Yeah, I think everybody outgrows it."
Soon after his SNL debut, Pete Davidson learned that performing in front of a national audience meant landing in hot water for some of his jokes. One of Davidson's most notorious moments on the show came after a Weekend Update segment called Pete Davidson's First Impressions of Midterm Election Candidates. Davidson joked that then-Texan congressional Republican candidate Dan Crenshaw could be mistaken for a, quote, "hitman in a porno movie," due to the eye patch he wears after losing his eye, quote, "in war or whatever." People were so outraged at Davidson's lack of respect for the former Navy SEAL that SNL invited Crenshaw to be on the next Weekend Update, where he received a rare public apology. The Washington Post called the apology, quote, "straightforward, earnest, and seemingly heartfelt." But in his stand-up special, Alive in New York, Davidson revealed that his mom forced him to apologize, though some speculated that it was the powers that be at SNL who were actually behind the apology. Pete Davidson's scandal with Dan Crenshaw was neither his first nor his last experience of controversy at Saturday Night Live. In a 2019 sketch about the R. Kelly and Michael Jackson documentaries, Pete Davidson appeared alongside Colin Jost on Weekend Update to discuss those controversies, and ended up in one himself. He joked,
"If you support the Catholic Church, isn't that like the same thing as being an R. Kelly fan? Only like one's music is significantly better."
Days later, the Catholic Church's Diocese of Brooklyn issued a statement on its website citing harassment from the show and demanding an apology. No apology was forthcoming, though, and Davidson told Charlamagne Tha God that he has grown to accept the backlash to his controversial jokes. "I hope you know it comes from a good place. I'm not a rotten individual, so, like, hopefully there won't be backlash, but I know it's coming. I don't rap or make music, so I can't. It's just how I'm expressing myself. I really hope people see what I'm talking about." While he had some fame from his resident young person bits and recurring SNL characters, Pete Davidson's relationship with Ariana Grande ramped up his notoriety. Though Davidson dated famous women before Grande, his personal life wasn't mentioned on the show beyond relatable punchlines on Weekend Update. Davidson acknowledges the significant career boost he got from his relationship with Grande, but he told Paper it was also a difficult lesson to learn, saying, "You forget that you have to approach it differently, which is really difficult for both people in the relationship, because the second the public knows you're together, it's already against you. You're losing. Now I'm just as private as possible." However, he was not happy with how SNL encouraged conversation about his engagement in Weekend Update skits, seemingly to capitalize on the hype.
Have you been enjoying all of the attention?
I hate it, it's awful.
Davidson told Charlamagne Tha God, "If I'm just fodder now, maybe I shouldn't be there." Davidson's personal issues haven't just been exploited by SNL for ratings, they have also caused waves behind the scenes. According to the New York Times, in late 2018, a police officer was sent to the SNL set to check on Davidson due to concern about his well-being after an Instagram post got people worried he might hurt himself. Fortunately, he was found safe, but it was just one of several troubling occurrences following his breakup with Ariana Grande. Davidson has also had to take time off for mental health. Unusually, though, SNL had him speak about it on Weekend Update before going into rehab. He joked,
"Oh, I'm going on a little vacation."
Why did you put it in quotes?
You know, the kind of vacation where, like, insurance pays for some of it, and they take your phone and shoelaces.
Many viewers appreciated his openness, which helped destigmatize mental health issues. Others, though, were again concerned that SNL was exploiting his troubles for ratings and headlines.
The show is, like, 8 hours long, and there's, like, 50 sketches a week. It seems weird you wouldn't use one of them to fight mental illness, but I guess that's not your style.
Despite his personal challenges and public relationship struggles, or perhaps because of them, Pete Davidson's career moved along impressively for a young comedian. Davidson sometimes even receives glowing reviews at the expense of the rest of the SNL cast. After the season 44 finale in May 2019, The Washington Post lauded Davidson as the shining star of the season, writing, quote, "The most interesting, funny, and even somewhat touching aspect of the season was Pete Davidson." And they weren't alone. Critics from The Atlantic and GQ, among others, also singled out Davidson as a breath of fresh air and a unique voice on the monolithic Saturday Night Live. The Washington Post praised the, quote, "magic of Davidson" in shedding light on the darkest parts of the human experience. Pete Davidson has changed a lot since being a 20-year-old newcomer on Saturday Night Live. Between various hairstyles, girlfriends, and scandals, though, one thing has remained consistent throughout Davidson's late-night tenure – his jokes about not belonging there. Most of us can relate to feeling imposter syndrome, but Davidson constantly undermines himself during interviews and even sketches. These repeated references go beyond his tried-and-true self-deprecating humor and hint that Davidson really does feel out of place and insecure at SNL. But is it all internal, or are there external reasons for him to feel as though he is on shaky ground? SNL is famously cutthroat, and Davidson has felt it. He told Charlamagne Tha God,
"Like, you're not gonna get coddled over there. The f***ing fear of getting fired there your first 3 years is horrible."
And rumor has it that Davidson's relationship with some of his fellow cast members has been rocky at times, in part because of Davidson's close relationship with showrunner Lorne Michaels. Beyond professional development, the two have also developed an endearing personal, father-son-like relationship. Davidson told Gold Derby, "My favorite there will always be Lorne, just because from day one, he's always been really understanding of me." That has apparently led to some jealousy, with an alleged insider telling Page Six that Davidson receives, quote, "star treatment" and that, quote, "Pete has a pretty cushy gig to say the least. The cast isn't into him." Davidson has picked up on the disdain towards him and is never one to stay quiet, voicing that he feels singled out on set. He told Charlamagne Tha God that the cast's opinion of him was reason enough to be done with SNL.
"I personally think I should be done with that show because they make fun of me on it. I don't know whose team they're playing for, really. If I'm the joke or I'm in on the joke."
Pete Davidson has been talking about leaving SNL for years. In 2020, he told Charlamagne Tha God, "I really wanted last year to be my last year, but you know, I'm still around and trying to knock it away." And following the season 46 finale in 2021, rumors swirled that he was finally quitting after he seemingly bid goodbye to the fans with a series of cryptic farewells, saying on Weekend Update,
"And I'm very grateful to be here, and it's been an honor to grow up in front of you guys, so thanks."
Yet, once again, Davidson ended up returning to SNL for season 47. So why does he keep coming back? It's reportedly due to his close relationship with Lorne Michaels. Davidson told Charlamagne Tha God, "For what I could do on the show, which is just barely anything, I feel like, yeah, I've done as much as I can over there, but happy to be there as long as Lorne likes me." He also told Gold Derby that he feels a responsibility towards the people on the show who have supported him through tough times, saying, "A few people there that have shown me extra love, they kept me around and I got to, in my eyes, redeem myself." whatever comes next in Davidson's future, he is poised and ready to be known as the next big star that started on SNL. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.